3, managerial leverage. This slide summarizes everything that I have to say in this video. A 5 kg ball with the right lever used can balance a 100 kg ball. Similarly, manager's time is the most precious time, and his activities are also going to be limited. So what activity the manager focuses on that has the highest impact depends on the leverage the manager exudes. In this case, the manager only needed to do 5 kg amount of work to handle 100 kg amount of work, right? So managerial leverage is the most important aspect to keep in mind for all you managers as you take on work. So what is the way to measure manager's output? So remember, the formula is that we've gone through so far. A manager's output is the output of his organization, so all of his direct reports, plus the output of the neighboring organization that the manager has influence over, because most likely those neighboring organizations will help the manager and his team to finish the work. So if you were to look at this formula that's in this chapter, output again of every individual is the sum total of activity times leverage, right? So if you do some activity and then what the leverage it creates, and you add all of those activities for every person, you get the output of the organization. Same for output of your neighboring organization. So there's going to be limited time, but the leverage is where you can have the maximum impact. If you pick activities that have the biggest impact for smallest effort, now all of a sudden your output is increasing. And there are three big areas that the managers need to focus on in terms of producing work. Activities could be of crisis management, sometimes when there is a problem and the direct report is not able to handle the situation well, then the manager needs to show by example how to do that work. And so jump in and as an individual contributor and actually do that work. So that's one type of an activity. Low leverage, but it could be also high leverage, as it could be turned into a coaching exercise. Now all of a sudden you have shown by example how to do this work well. Improving processes is another activity, which is a high leverage activity. If you find issues that are repeating, and if you introduce processes that help eliminate those issues or check for those issues early on, then you are actually having a higher leverage, because now everyone's benefiting from that interjection. So teaching is another area, right, where you are actually improving the level of understanding for everyone in the team, and that has the biggest influence. Organizations that your team depends on, like for example, if you are working on developing software, you probably depend on a couple of dozen teams, if not at least a dozen teams, who would help you, you know, for your source code management, for your build, for your deployment, for traffic management, and there's a huge list of people that you need, but there's going to be two or three that actually are very much closer to the work that you do and your organization does. So influencing them to help your team better is also a big area of activity. So the improving processes. The third being developing a sense of purpose, developing a sense of strategy as to what should we be doing. There are going to be 50 things that you could be doing, but which one's the best that will have the maximum impact for our customers, for the users, for whatever your factory is producing? So developing that sense of purpose, that sense of direction, saying, hey, we're going to go east, west, or north, or south, has a huge impact. Then activity and leverage starts going in that direction. So manager needs to understand that there's increased leverage in each of these. A purpose has the highest leverage. Processes, improvement, teaching, coaching, even, you know, slightly less, but still very high. Individual contribution, lowest leverage, but can be turned into higher leverage. So this is an important simple formula: activity and leverage. All those activities that you do is an important way to measure the sum total of manager's output. So what's an example of a high leverage activity? We went through some of them, but coaching, right? If you have a session where you up-level the skills of everyone in your team, that's a huge leverage. Delegation, right? Like if you get someone to step up to take up a big responsibility now that you were doing, now all of a sudden you can scale up yourself to having multiple of those high-level managers and senior individual contributors to pick up that work. So if you can delegate, now all of a sudden you are scaling. But there's a thin line of delegating in such a way that you don't abdicate the project, meaning you have no idea what's going on in that project, but also not delegating in such a way that you're still meddling. You're like micromanaging. That just kills morale. So delegation is an art. How do you do that well? It's an important aspect to go deep in a separate video. But doing it in such a way that you have 6 to 8 people where you probably need half a day, depending on the maturity of the person, half a day per week, that leaves 6 to 8 people at max that you can have. But if the individuals in your team are higher maturity, you can delegate with less effort. But make sure that you don't abdicate the project when you have no idea. They're doing it, I don't know. Then as a manager, you lose credibility. So delegation has high leverage, but using it with some guardrails is how many direct reports, what do they do? Performance review is another high leverage activity. Now you're completely changing, you're writing down your thoughts. You're writing down your thoughts as to what should this person be focusing on, but also what they have done well that they should double down on. So this fundamentally changes the whole year for the person. Ideally, you're giving feedback right at the moment, but this is a very critical high leverage activity where you actually write things down in terms of what worked, what needs to improve, and what are the next steps. And it's something that's very actionable. So performance reviews, team meetings, one-on-ones, team meetings, lead meetings, right? These are all great setup if you do it well with a specific agenda and you ask people to prepare and participate. You could make it a very high leverage, engaging activity where people feel a sense of belonging, people feel a sense of being heard, and that they make decisions together. Those are all high leverage activity. Again, developing a strategy by actually understanding all of the trends, understanding what are the long poles, what are the limiting steps, what are the bottlenecks that we've covered in the previous videos, is an important, super high leverage activity for the manager, right? Understanding customer needs. This is probably the most important area. So if as a manager you feel you have no time for strategy, you're just executing, then probably you have too many direct reports. Probably you're not putting in the amount of work that you should be putting in. And so there's no substitute of hard work. So you need to get to a strategy point where you are able to develop that sense of purpose. And one way you can do this is by organizing your calendar. Make sure that you are actually reducing low leverage activities. Your time is probably the most critical resource, and that's something that you cannot really buy, cannot negotiate. So organize your calendar, figure out how there are uninterrupted time slots in your calendar that you can actually do work, you can actually think about things, you can actually write in detail. And if there are unplanned works that keep coming up, keep a log. What are the issues that happened that were not planned? And at some point, you'd also have to have a way to say no. You should say, hey, you cannot really do more than certain activities if you're not scaled your team well. So scaling correctly, but also saying no when you cannot take on more work is an important activity, which increases your leverage because now you can focus on the most important aspects and you can actually do well. So if you do all of this well and increase your leverage, then you will be able to take decisions that are important for your team. Again, decision-making is the most important managerial task. And the way you get to that step of decision-making is initially when you're new to the team, everything is new. So informational gathering is probably the most important step where you try to understand everything as to what's going on. Through casual conversation, through one-on-ones, through team meetings, through understanding, through the deep dives, jumping on to issues and all of that. So information gathering is the basis. And all of your meetings is going to be the point where you actually ask the right questions. Eventually, you'll spot trends as you start logging things. Then you can make effective decisions once you understand the system, understand the people, understand the gaps, understand customer needs and all of that. So if you think if you see that you're, delaying decisions and not making decisions, then that's a problem. Then you're not working on high leverage activity. Then so look back, organize your calendar, go back to understanding what are those things that you can delegate and things like that that we discussed in the previous few slides. So don't delay decision making. It's probably very important. Pre-plan, structure meetings, make sure that everything has a clear agenda and that you're actually making progress. And focus on the top two or three things. You know, there's going to be always 50 things. The work will never get over and you can never be done. So figuring out what are those one or two or maybe at max three most important things for your organization that will have the highest leverage is an art. And over time, you'll get it. But that's something that you need to keep honing, get feedback, and improve on. Okay, so few pieces of reflection from this video and from this chapter. Hold a scheduled one-on-one. Explain to them what you want in that one-on-one from your team members. You should meet 0.5 person a week, right? 0.5 days a week per person. And so have a prepared schedule of what you want them to cover, and then also have a way in which you can bring in points that you're already writing in maybe a shared document. And so have a structured one-on-one. Make the employees run your one-on-ones. Make them prepared. And then have for a good enough time. If half an hour is just way too short to go deep, then have a 1 hour maybe every 2 weeks if that's helpful. Take an ad hoc tour. Information gathering is probably the most important step that you continuously need to do. So do your skip levels if you need to. Talk to adjacent org people. Monitor the tasks that you've delegated, right? How frequently you'll monitor so that it's not meddling, but it's also not abdicating the project. Keep track for the work. That are you doing high leverage or low leverage work? And then generate a plan of action to do high leverage work and forecast the demand of your time by doing planning. And what are the top two things that you'll be working on? That's part of this. All right, thanks.